for those who did not intend but would like to join us in this Bible study, this is quite a special one because it concerns all of us. We were born in a family. But being born in a family is not enough. We have to make family. Even with you, my little girl, you are part of making family. Every one of us has a role. It's not just the job of one of the parents or both. It's a job of not so much of a breadwinner. It's a work that is entailing all of us. And in this evening, reflecting on the family, we shall look at it from a biblical, from a scriptural standpoint offered to us by the church in this coming Sunday of the Holy Family, Feast of the Holy Family, December 31. So you have there on the board the gospel taken from the Gospel of Luke, and this will be about the presentation in the temple. And we shall have the first reading taken from the book of Sirach. No? That is a wisdom writing. And finally, we have from the second reading, for the second reading, the letter of Paul to the Christian community in a Greek city called Colossae. So, we have these three important texts of the Word of God that can give us a base, a foundation in what consists God's will, God's design for what a family should be. So we shall have, Ariel, the reading of the Gospel from the Gospel of John.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Luke. When the days were completed for their purification according to the law of Moses, Joseph and Mary took Jesus up to Jerusalem to present him to the Lord, just as it is written in the law of the Lord. Every male that opens the womb shall be consecrated to the Lord, and to offer the sacrifice of a pair of turtle doves or two young pigeons, in accordance with the dictate in the law of the Lord. Now there was a man in Jerusalem whose name was Simeon. This man was righteous and devout, awaiting the consolation of Israel, and the Holy Spirit was upon him. It had been revealed to him by the Holy Spirit that he would not die before he had seen the Christ of the Lord. Led by the Spirit, he came into the temple, and when the parents brought in the child Jesus to perform the custom of the law in regard to him, Simeon took him into his arms and blessed God, saying, "Now, Master, you may let your servant go in peace according to your word, for my eyes have seen your salvation, which you prepared in sight of all the peoples, a light for revelation to the Gentiles, and glory for your people Israel." The child's father and mother were amazed at what was said about him. Simeon blessed them and said to Mary, his mother, "Behold, this child is destined for the fall and rise of many in Israel, and to be a sign that will be contradicted, and suffering like a sword will pierce your own heart, so that the thoughts of many hearts may be revealed. When they had fulfilled all the prescriptions of the law of the Lord, they returned to Galilee, to their own town of Nazareth. The child grew and became strong, filled with wisdom, and the favor of God was upon him. The Holy Gospel.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ. So, our usual way so that we could have a more solid understanding is by my question, using the text, you will read the text, whether there or through this exploring God's Word. In so doing, after the reading by Ariel, and with my questions and your answer, it can happen that three times the Word of God kind of gets more and more deep into the recesses of our soul, of our minds, and of our hearts. So asking the questions coming from the text of the Gospel, we are in chapter 2 of the Gospel of Luke, verse 22 first. Verse 22. What did it say? What happened to the Holy Family of Joseph, Mary, and Jesus when the days were completed, 40 days, that means, for the purification? Please say, when? Joseph and Mary up to Jerusalem to present him to the Lord. So the purification is the purification of the woman. Lumabas kasi ang dugo when she gave birth. And so she is being cleansed of that blood of birth. And 40 days after, she might have a new menstruation. And that will be more of the purified one. So, purifying her, they went to the temple because that was the law of Moses to purify the mother of the child, of a firstborn particularly. But what else was this presentation about in verse 23? Just as it is written, so, we have a consecration of the child to the Lord according to the law. And what should they be offering for this consecration? So, if you are simple folk, you are just required a pair of doves. Or pigeons. If you have more money, you can offer a lamb or a goat. If you are more rich, you can even offer a cow. So from Wagyu to lamb chop, or just pigeon. Okay? Notice now, three times the word in accordance with the law. Diba? They were to purify according to the law of Moses, and they were to present him in the law, no, or as it is written in the law, and therefore to offer in accordance with the dictates in the law. Gumagawa sila nang nararapat sa kalooban ng Diyos na kanagda, nakasulat sa scripture. Ito yung kanyang tinatawag nating kalooban at batas. Kalooban at kagustuhan. Second part. Sino ba ang naandun sa Jerusalem and what kind of a person is he qualified in verse 25? Now, his name was Simeon. Ayon, righteous, devout, and most importantly, the Holy Spirit was upon him. What did the Holy Spirit reveal to him in verse 26? That he would not die? Christ the Lord. And then in verse 27, what did he do because he was led by the Spirit? Custom of the law in regard to him. Yan lang muna, ha? Kita niyo naman, three times naman. Isa, law. The other, the Spirit. The living reason, the living inspiration of the law. So he was having the Spirit on him. It was revealed to him and he was led by the same Spirit. Tatlong action yan. No? Presence of the Spirit and revealed by the Spirit, led by the Spirit. Now, this Simeon in verse 28, what does he do? Simeon? What did he say? Verse 29? According to your word. Yung sabi doon, di ba? He was revealed that he would not die until he had seen the Christ, the Lord. Now he said, pwede na. Pwede na akong pumanaw. Bakit daw? Ano yung kanyang sinabi? What did his eyes see? Which? So makikita to ng lahat. Sino ba yung lahat? In verse 32 is all the peoples of the world. Who are the people of the world? Ah? Ang yabang ng mga Hudyo, no? Di ba? Ang tawag dyan, the Israelites, the Jews, the people of God, against the rest of the world. That's it. The rest of the world is not Israelite, is not God's people. And yet, in Simeon's proclamation, light to the Gentiles, to the people of Israel, glory. They were chosen that he would be born from that tribe, from that people. Dun siya naging tao. Ang Diyos pinili na ang kanyang anak ay maging tao as a Jew, as an Israelite, as a member of the people of the covenant. Kung kakampi nyo ang Hamas at Palestinian, ingat kayo. Diba? Kasi in this sense, pinroclaim na ito yung kanyang mga tao, God's people, ang Israeli people. I'm not too sure about the IDF, Israel Defense Forces. But what I'm saying, you have still to regard that these people continue to have a covenant, that God is faithful to a covenant with them. Okay. Huwag na tayo magpolitika. So now, what was the reaction of the parents of this little child, a 40-day-old child? Verse 33. And then, what did Simeon tell them? Wow, a sign to be contradicted, rise and fall of many. And therefore, in verse 35, what did he say of the mother? So that? Ayon. When you say sign, kunyari, left turn, di ba? Nakalagay doon. Left turn, heaven. Sign yon. So, nasa iyo. It becomes a sign of contradiction. Bakit? May ba gustong kumanan? Not necessarily everybody turns left. And that will be a source of suffering. Hindi lahat susunod sa batang ito. Light, ha? Of the Gentiles. Glory of His people. And yet, it doesn't mean that he will be saved from suffering. And so the mother too. Bakit kaya si Joseph hindi kasama? Namatay na siya before the sufferings happened. Except one, yung flight to Egypt, the first sorrow of the Blessed Virgin. So now, lumaktaw tayo, 36, 37, 38. We went immediately to verse 39. So, ano daw yung katapusan? Okay. But this is more important. What happened to the 40-day-old child? Okay. Tao ba si Jesus? Yes or no? Are you sure? And what is the proof biblically? He will grow. Imagine, ah, not only physically strong, but wisdom, karunungan, with wisdom, and with grace, favor. Hindi lang physical, hindi lang intellectual, spiritual. He would grow as any human person needs to grow. How will he grow? Ha? Importante ito. They returned to Galilee, to their town of Nazareth, and that's where he will grow with his parents and with the people that surrounds him. Wait. Sa Gospel ni Matthew, that child will be hunted. And so, may panahon that they have to go to Egypt. Maybe for a year and a half, we don't know. It was only probably when Jesus was 4 years old, he returned to Galilee from Bethlehem. With the visit of the Magi next Sunday, January 7, we shall have the reading of the visit of the Magi from the East. And the first sorrow to the Blessed Mother will happen. So more or less, pwede natin pag-usapan next week. Eh, wala pala ako dito eh. I'm on retreat. Na si Jesus, hindi niya na-meet ang Magi sa manger. Although nilalagay natin yung three kings. He was there in the manger for a day or two, no more. After the census, they had already a place. Nag-alis na ibang tao eh. So most probably, no? They stayed in Bethlehem for some time. And about a year and a half after, came the Magi. Kasi when Herod said, "When did you see the star?" 2 years already had passed. When they said that a child is born. So Jesus, naglalakad na. And if you would read the Gospel of Matthew, he was inside a house with his mother. And Joseph was not there because naghahanap buhay. Diba? Nagtatrabaho na siya. So, huwag niyong ilagay ang gospel sa Belen. Ha? Yung Belen is a summary of the gospel, plural. But not the chronological situation of the gospel. Okay. Thanks be to God, we are there. Kita niyo, verse 39, ang ending, balik tayo sa batas. When all the prescriptions of the law were fulfilled by Mary and Joseph, they now return back home. And that's where the family life brought about growth. Physically, intellectually, you know, morally, and spiritually in grace for this child. Ngayon, punta po tayo sa first reading. Ano po ba ang first reading? It's from a book of wisdom. Ito po'y karunungan. Hindi po ito a book of instruction. It's not about law. It's about the fulfillment or the practice, the correct practical a performance of the law. That's when you become a wise person. And that's the book of Sirach. So let's have again. Sige na, Evelyn.
A reading from the book of Sirach. God sets a father in honor over his children. A mother's authority he confirms over her sons. Whoever honors his father atones for sins and preserves himself from them. He stores up riches when reverses his mother. Who reverses his mother? Whoever honors his father is gladdened by children, and when he prays, is heard. Whoever reverses his father will live a long life. He who obeys his father brings comfort to his mother. My son, take care of your father when he is old. Grieve him not as long as he lives. Even if his mind fails, be considerate with him. Revile him not all the days of his life. Kindness to a father will not be forgotten. Firmly planted against the debt of your sins, a house raised in justice to you. The word of the Lord.
That's why I promised that this is quite special. If we would base family life on the word of God in the Old Testament, this is a fantastic reading. So sana yung mga anak dito, yung mga anak nyo, pabasa nyo to. I'm so happy this nice girl is with her dad. No? And she would understand what is to be a daughter or a son. Let's start with a deeper understanding. So, sino po dito may mga magulang pang matatanda na? Isa, dalawa, tatlo, apat, lima. Okay. Tatay, nanay din. Both. Kayo po. Father? Ayan. Mother niyo, wala na? Mahirap maging balong lalaki. Sino po sa inyo? Mother na lang. Kayo? Cynthia, ikaw? Sino yung... Sino nalalabi? Mother. Okay? Wala na? Mother? Okay. Pwede rin dito mother or father. So, verse 2. Sino pumili ng ating mga magulang? Verse 2. And then? Yan ha. Itagaan niyo yan ha. Sa bato. Hindi kayo namili ng tatay at nanay sa Greenbelt o sa Glorieta. Ayala Mall man yan o SM. Binigyan tayo ng tatay o nanay. Kahit sila'y damuho, walang hiya. Yan ay kaloob ng Diyos. Ha? God sets a father over his children, a mother's authority he confirms over her sons. Pakisabi to sa mga Yanson pamilya sa Bacolod. Maraming pinag-uusapan ngayon doon. Ngayon, ito ang consequence. Ha? Consequence to, ha? Ng pagsunod sa kalooban ng Diyos. Honor your father and your mother, the fourth commandment. So in verse 3, ano yung first consequence or reward? Whoever? So nawala ang kasalanan. Napagbayaran ang mga pagkakasala. Number one, ha? Hindi nyo kaya yan, simply. Ito, mas gusto ng iba. Number four. O, kayamanan na yan. Number six. Ano pa? Whoever reveres. O, tenan nyo. Pang-apat. He is heard. Pinapakinggan ang dasal niya. Pang-apat na yan, ha? Pang-lima, verse 6. And pangalawa, who obeys his father brings comfort. So, lima yan. Long life. Magkakaroon ka ng anak. Marinig ang iyong dasal. Ha? Magkakaroon ka ng kayamanan. Mawawalan ka ng bisa ang iyong pagkakasala. Honor your father and your mother has these consequences. Ayaw pa? O sige. So, ano ang payo? Di ba nag-skip to eh. So, sa verse 12, ano ang payo ng man of wisdom? My son. O, pinag-uusapan na natin, ha? Baka yung mga tatay nyo na to, nanay nyo, matatanda na. Sige, ha? Huwag nyong pagsasamantalahan, huwag nyong sisigawan, ha? Huwag nyong babaliwalain pag matanda na ang inyong mga magulang. Verse 13, ito ha? Even if, be considerate, revile him not all the days. So kung siya'y ulyanin, ang tawag sa dementia, Alzheimer's, pero ang tawag dun sa amin sa Batangas, huli-huli, paulit-ulit. Huwag niyo naman sabihin, eh sinabi ko na nga eh. Relax. Ulitin niyo ang sagot ng malumanay. Even if his mind fails. Bakit? Bakit? Verse 14. Ayon. Hindi, pag sinabi mo dito, kindness will not be forgotten. By whom? So to not to say the name of God in vain, they take away the name of God. So they make it into a passive form. Or if you put it active, God will not forget kindness to a father. Kaya sabi ko sa inyo eh, kung lahat lang nandito, nandito, napakahalaga nito this coming Sunday. This is repeated every family feast of the Holy Family. Ito. So just imagine, bakit kaya ang maliit na batang yon, sanggol, 40 days old, bakit kaya siya grew strong, wisdom, and grace? Bakit kaya?
He's the son of God.
Ako, hindi ka nakikinig, cheat. Pasok tayo dapat sa scripture, Cynthia. Ayun. Teka muna, sino ba si Jesus? Sabi mo, Son of God. Sino sinunod niya? Tao. Bakit? No. Binigay sa kanya ng Diyos. God sets a father. Si Jose ang tatay mo dito. Si Maria ang nanay mo. Huwag mong tingnan ako. Sila. You will grow in wisdom, in strength, and in grace. Sino man yung damuhong yan, sino man na naging walang hiyang yan. Talaga. Sino man yung ulyanin na yan, sundin nyo ang natatama. Yay kalooban ng Panginoon. And you will grow. You will grow. Not only in strength physically, but wisdom. Malalaman nyo ang katwiran, ano ang tama na pananaw. At sa lahat ng Diyos, mabibiyayaan kayo. Dapat natin ishoot eh, sa first reading ang gospel. Kasi we will have the presentation on February 20, February 2. December 25 eh. Diba? 40 days. 25, 26, 27, 28, 29, 30. 31, 7. Plus 31. Edi, ano na? Ayun. Paano ba? Sabi natin, 25. 26, 27, 28, 29, 30, 31. Plus 31 days of January. 6 plus 31, 37. 1, 2, di 39. O tama, bilang mo yung 25 as the first day. 40 days, February 2. Candelaria. Di ba February 2 is the feast of the Candelaria, of the light? Iba ang homily namin on that feast. It's about the light and there will be darkness. A light has shone. Pero dito, ang homily namin, ang dapat nating kalalabasan, kalooban ng Diyos. Ang mga magulang ay bahagi ng kalooban ng Diyos. Sino man sila. Doon tayo, we will really grow in the eyes of God. Mysterious, di ba? As mysterious as the incarnation is the mystery of our lives. Kaya alam nyo, yung may problema at the age of 50, ang tawag nila eh, nagkakaroon siya ng midlife. Ako po, tapos na. Midlife crisis na po ako. Yung may midlifing kasi may unresolved situations in childhood. Babalikan mo dapat yon. Kasi meron kang tinatawag na unfinished business. At giginiling ka ng Diyos at middle age. Otherwise, sayang ang the next 30 to 40 years. Magwawala ka. Pag hindi mo inako ang inner child mo, magwawala ka. Ang tawag sa'yo sa mga lalaki, D.O.M. Dirty old men. Ibang klase yan. So there is a process of the inner child thanks to psychology of today. The psychologist of adolescence were those who underwent adolescent problems. Then they became psychologists of their experience. The psychologists of midlife are mga 60, 70-year-olds today because they underwent their midlife. They can now speak of their experience. No? So, pinag-uusapan yan. Ang tawag, there's a book, From Noon to Nightfall. Pag dumating ka na sa tanghalian, papuntang paglubog ng araw, ang tawag dyan sa buhay, palubog ka na rin. Obvious yun eh. Lulubog at lulubog din tayo. Kaya, anong ginawa mo para dumating sa tanghali ay hindi ginagawa pagpupuntang dapit hapon. Naglalaba ka, nagdidilig ka sa umaga. Kasi papasmahin ang halaman sa hapon. Sa tanggal na ng kanyang mainit, lalagyan mo ng tubig, pasmado. Pati yung labada mo, hindi matutuyo kung maglalaba ka sa hapon. There are things you do before 40. And there are things you already do differently after 40 or 50. Ang hirap tanggapin yan. Simula kay Father Francis Gustilo. Yes po, hirap po yan. You are not the same as before. And normally, what you thought succeeded before does not necessarily succeeds now. It's a completely different context. So, kahit anong galing ni LeBron James, 38 na siya. Kahit anong galing ni Michael Jordan, hindi na siya. Diba? Masasaktan ka lang. Mababalian ka lang. Diba? So, people have to know how to accept life. Okay. So, pagtitingnan po natin, no? Nakita nyo po, when we compare the gospel with the first reading, I tried already to say, pagtitingnan nyo yung words, ano magkapareho sa first reading at sa gospel? Una sa lahat. Ano sa lahat? Ang una. Sino mga importante sa dalawang readings? Sino mga characters? Parents, di ba? Father, mother, children. Family, di ba? Hindi lang eh. Sino pa? Ang Diyos. At ano sa Diyos? Ang kalooban niya. Di ba sa first sa gospel, they followed what was according to the law. But, andun din, ang Diyos Espiritu Santo. So, yung ginawa nila sa anak ng Diyos ay ayon sa kalooban ng Ama at sa inspirasyon, sa prodding ng Espiritong Banal. So, ang pamilya, napapaloob, no? Ang pamilya, hindi mag-isa eh. You're not on your own. The Father, the Son, and the Spirit are part of that family. Led by the Spirit, because of Jesus Christ, they perform this according to the law of God. So, ito ngayon ang clincher. Ha? Gusto ko magbasa o si Chit? Si Sean. Si Chit na lang. Si Sean. Nagsalamin kagad o. Oh. Yung second reading, page 42, Colossians.
A reading from the letter to the Colossians. Brothers and sisters, you're God's chosen ones, holy and beloved. Put on, then, heartfelt compassion, kindness, humility, gentleness, and patience, bearing with one another and forgiving one another. If one has a grievance against another, as the Lord has forgiven you, so must you also do. And over all this, put on love, that is the bond of perfection. And let the peace of Christ control your hearts, the peace into which we are also called in one body, and be thankful. Let the word of Christ dwell in you richly, as in all wisdom you teach and admonish one another, singing psalms, hymns, and spiritual songs with gratitude in your hearts to God. Whatever you do, in word or in deed, do everything in the name of the Lord Jesus, giving thanks to God the Father through him. Wives, be subordinate to your husbands, as is proper in the Lord. Husbands, love your wives and avoid any bitterness toward them. Children, obey your parents in everything, for this is pleasing to the Lord. Fathers, do not nag your children, so that they may not be discouraged. The word of the Lord.
Thank you. So, pagtitingnan natin itong verses na to, 12 to 21, something like 10 verses actually, you will find na ang most important is yung first part, 12 up to verse 16. 12, 13, 14, 15, 16. Kita nyo bang kating-hati? 12, 13, 14, 15, 16. Tapos, itong pasakalye, introduction na to, kailangan i-apply sa next 5. 17, 18, 19, 20, 21. And yeah, to 21. 17, 18, 19, 20, and 21. So yung una, para sa lahat, maging babae, wife, maging lalaki, husband, maging anak, o magulang. Di ba? It's about family pa rin eh. Pero yung second part, ano yung dapat mangyari kung bubuhayin mo ang first part? Tingnan natin ngayon. So, ang first verse, verse 12, letter A, sino ba tayo? Who are we? You are holy and beloved. So, on the same verse 12, ano daw dapat nating parang damitin o mapasa atin? Put on? Ayon. So, ito'y common, maging magulang ka, asawa, babae, lalaki, or mga anak. Ito'y common sa pagpapamilya. Put on compassion mula sa puso, kindness, humility, gentleness, and patience. Bakit? Verse 13. Bearing with one another, if one has a grievance, and bakit daw? As the Lord? Yon. Ang basihan, bakit tayo magiging kind, compassionate, patient, humble sa isa't isa? Eh kasi ganun ang ginawa ng Diyos sa atin. Di ba? Okay? So just imagine ang pamilya na ganito ang kalidad ng mga relationships. Heartfelt compassion, kindness, humility, gentleness, patience, bearing with one another, forgiving one another. Bakit? The Lord has forgiven you. You must also do. Pero, suma total, ano sang sinabi ni Paul in verse 14? And over? Ayan. Ito'y dapat magbunga o pinagkakaugatan nito ang love. Ano man love? Ang Diyos ay pag-ibig. God is love. Ang pinagkakaugatan nito, kasi ginawa sa iyo ng Diyos, Diyos din. Put on God. Sabi niya, put on heartfelt compassion, kindness, humility, gentleness, patience, bearing one another, forgiving, as the Lord has done to you. Therefore, put on love. Put on God. That is the bond of perfection. Ano kalalabasan on verse 15? The peace. And then? And therefore, in verse 16, as in all wisdom, you teach one another, singing psalms. So, ang una, teaching of the apostles. Ito yung word of God at admonishing and teaching of those who met the Lord. Sabi ni Paul. Pero, sa panalangin, psalms, singing. He did not put here the breaking of the bread. No? So, maging sa turo na ginawa ng mga saksi ni Kristo at sa inyong pagiging isang katawan sa panalangin, ito ang mangyari dapat sa inyo. Kayo'y bayan ng Diyos. Ito sana ang mamalagi at siyang maghari sa inyo. Ang Diyos at ang kanyang pamamaraan ng pagturing sa inyo. Compassion, gentleness, humility, kindness, and patience, bearing with one another, forgiving. So therefore, i-apply natin sa pag-aasawa at pagpapamilya. So first, verse 17, anong pasakali niya? giving thanks to God the Father through Him. So, anuman ang gagawin mo sa pamilya, gawin mo sa ngalan ni Jesus. Bakit? Kayong mga asawang babae, anong dapat mong gawin? Ayan. Ang basa ng maraming babae, masama. Wives, be subordinate to their husband. Mali. As it is proper in the Lord. Dahil sa Diyos, hindi dahil sa asawa mo. You submit to your husband because you submit to the Lord. Bakit? Eh, siya binigay ng Diyos sa iyo eh. Para sa inyong mga anak. Ngayon, sa husband naman, love your wives. Tapos ano? And avoid? O, huwag niyong hatiin. Magkasama yan. Submissive ang wife sa husband as to the Lord. But the husband loves his wife and avoids bitterness towards her. Ang hirap mahalin ang asawang hindi submissive. Ang hirap naman mag-submit sa asawang hindi nagmamahal. Di ba reciprocal yan? O ngayon, ano reciprocity ng mga magulang sa kanilang anak? Una muna, children. Verse 30. Bakit? Yun, i-connect dapat sa bata to. Bakit do you have to obey your parents in everything? This is pleasing to the Lord. Natutuwa ang Diyos dyan. And therefore, para naman, i-obey kayo ng mga anak nyo, ano sabi sa mga magulang? Ayon. Game na naman ikaw. Video game ka na naman. Diba? Hindi sila, nagbi-video game sila. Kasi hindi niya naman binibigyan oras kausapin. Alam niyo pinakamaganda dito? Makipag-video gaming kayo sa kanya. At pag-usapan niyo nangyari sa laro. Di ba? Ay, hindi. Pambata yan. Ay, yun ang buhay ng bata eh. I was like that in the recent vacation ko with my brother and my sister-in-law and my nephews who are in their 30s, late 30s even, 39, 35, 34. May guest kaming 15-year-old. Walang ginawa kundi sa kanyang video game. Wala naman nakialam sa kanya eh. Wala naman lumapit sa kanya para siya kausapin one-on-one. At yung pinag-uusapan namin, kami, mga nakakatanda, nasa 70 years old, 60, 88 yung isa, eh tukol sa aming nakaraan, eh paano magko-connect si 15-year-old? Di ba? Mas connected siya sa kanyang video game. At least may kasama siya, meron siyang kalaro, meron siyang nagkakaunawaan sa kanya. Ayun eh. Diba? So, it's hard to obey fathers who are nagging. It's hard naman not to nag, children that do not obey. Reciprocal din. So therefore, ano ang flavor ng second reading sa ating coming Feast of the Holy Family? Ano yung connect? Cheat.
Not because he is really good, but because he loves God. There
So ang nagko-connect sa tatlo ay ang Diyos. At yung pamamaraan, ang style ng Diyos sa kanyang pamamayani, sa kanyang pagsisimuno sa atin. Because kalooban lang ba niya yan o ginawa ng kanyang anak? Yon. Hindi lang to kalooban ng Diyos as instruction. Binuhay yan ng anak ng Diyos. Yung instruction na yan. Correct. So, pwede ka nang mag-homily next Sunday. Ha? Ikaw na, tatawagin kita, lagot. Hindi ka, lagot ka. Di ba? Correct. Di ba? Si Kristo ang wisdom. Si Kristo ang sulat ni San Pablo. Di ba nakalagay dito, oh? Andiyan, napakalaki, oh. Let the peace of Christ control your hearts. Let the word of Christ dwell in you. So let's now end with saying, why on a Christmas octave? Diba? Nasa octave yan eh. Now, within the 8 days of Christmas, nagkataon ngayon ng Christmas, hindi Sunday. Di ba? Otherwise, last year yun eh, ang January 1, Sunday din. Yung octave, mawawala si Holy Family. Hindi, last year, alam niyo kung sino si Holy Family? December 30. Yun ang Holy Family. Alangang araw. Hindi birthday, kamatayan. Kasi mahirap gawin sa December 31. So, in between talaga the two feasts, no, of Christmas and New Year, the circumcision of the Lord, Mother of God, andun yung Holy Family. So, kalooban ba ng Diyos na maging tao ang kanyang anak? Yes or no? Ito yung kulatilya dyan ng mga lawyer. Therefore, kulatilya, kalooban ng Diyos na tayong mabuhay sa loob ng isang pamilya. Kung kalooban ng Diyos, ikaw ay ipanganak. Kalooban ng Diyos, ipanganak kanyang anak, no? Maging tao. Kalooban ng Diyos, ipanganak siya sa loob ng isang pamilya. Kalooban niya yan. So sabi natin, kung ikaw ay pinanganak, kasama dyan, pinanganak ka within a context of a family. And you know, the family is being destroyed today. Diba? Andyan, si death, divorce, euthanasia, abortion, transgender, and homosexuality. The family is being destroyed. Homosexuality more than it's homosexual marriage. Imagine lumaban as Miss Universe a transgendered man as a Miss Spain. Diba? Doon galing ang ating kayamanan ng pananampalataya sa Spain. And Spain proposes now that also a transgendered person can fight for the Miss Universe. So, next time ba ang ating contestant is si Vice Ganda? Diba? Yes, please. Distortion, yes. What is the solution? Sa akin, there are two things. Go local. So make sure you take care of your family. That's the solution muna. Continue to foster elements of what we have said in your own family. Especially siguro, if you're becoming the matriarch of the family, then exercise that presence nyo in the family. That's the first, go local. Kasi you have to begin somewhere. I think we have to begin in our own families. Pangalawa, be an advocate. Magsalita ka. Maging sa anak mo, sa pamangkin mo, sa apo mo. Not so much yung pagalitan mo, as much as storyahan mo. Alam niyo, marami ngayon storytelling. Ang paraan ng parang paghubog sa mga bata, bigyan mo ng storya ng iyong mga ninuno. Kung maganda ang inyong kaugatan, maganda siguro. So this Christmas, since, you know, I have this fortune that my mother collected 20,000 pictures of the family from my great-grandparents to my grandparents to every sibling, 9 of them, she collected pictures and we put it into an album, into albums, including my story, my brother's story. We have 162 albums. We did it for her 90th birthday. So to this day, dumating itong pamangkin ko sa pinsan, andun din yung pinsan ko, the eldest, 88 years old. Her daughter is my inaanak. Her two daughters are my kind of grandnieces. And so I told them, do you want, kasi mga American mind na, do you want to know your roots? And you know, when they opened the albums of their grandparents, of their mother and father, then they realize there's a story to speak about. No? So pictures and memories are important. I had the fortune to sit with my mom for 2 months during lunchtime. I was recovering from a knee prosthesis, a knee implant, and I asked my superior to stay at home where there would be physical rehab in Makati. And I had lunchtime with my mom. She did not know we are preparing this on her 90th birthday, a kind of story of her significant others. And then we ask others to write about how they were impressed by our mother. So we put a little coffee table book, not hardbound. We called it Reminiscences and Impressions. And it has remained for us, I think. So I started to write what my mother told me about her significant others, especially starting with her grandmother, our great-grandmother, who was her Lola, who was her mother and father to her, who were their siblings. Among the siblings, who was the soulmate? Among her titas and titos, what was her relationship? So I think it's very important. And then finally, we also kind of put into a lamination of plastic 60 love letters of my dad to my mom. That she kept in a shoebox until she turned 90. The first letter, I think, the first time they met was in 1937 when my father sent a Christmas card. Being an officer of Insurer Life, it had his name imprinted on the Christmas card. I don't know why. There is no name of my mom. There's no signature of my dad. Probably it came with a gift. That is the first that we think my father did not even dare say dear or affectionately. Takot lang yata niya. Baka hindi siya tanggapin. But we have small cards of my father sending her gifts when she was in PGH, when she was sick. And through the Japanese War, she kept it. O, diba? Wala kayong ganun, meron kami. Anyway, so there is something to say about family this coming Sunday. Okay, so what could be God telling you this evening? What would be the feast of the Holy Family according to the biblical text we have studied? Yes?
No, I like it. I like it because it's a concrete model that ang origin and survival of the Holy Family. Maraming ang kumuha ng Church of the Holy Family, Fiesta. But you know, Father, sorry, reality, when I read the newspaper, when I read it ako, why do you say it? Parang ungrateful. May nagsasabi, ako yung nagsasabi, kung pwede lang piliin ang pamilya ko.
Ayan, siyempre. Sa frustration, kung pwede ko lang piliin. Okay. Right. So we need to know better the meaning of family life. Ano? Of you also. Yes. From the scriptural texts. Yes. Yes.
Everything in life, Father, is a gift. Our Father is a gift. Same as our mother, our children. They are all gifts from God. In the first reading, it is said that God sets the Father in honor of the children. And the authority of the mother is confirmed also by the father. Now, when God gave us our life, when God created man and woman, God puts a law so that man will have a fullness of life. Now, the model or the Holy Family, kung mapansin po natin, tatlo. The Father, the Mother, the Child. No? Pero may isa pa dyan, yung God. Bago nagkaroon ng child, kinasal muna ang mag-asawa. Merong study na yung mga hindi kinasal, yung nag-live-in lang or hindi binasbasan ng pare or whatever, religion, marami ang naghihiwalay. Because, aminin natin na ang family is under constant attack by the devil. Yun ang unang dinidestroy ni Satan. Pag ma-destroy niya yung family, the whole humanity will follow. So, it is the responsibility of the parents to enforce these laws given by God to defend the family against the lies of the devil, like yung mga euthanasia, same-sex marriage, transgender. These are all designed by the devil to destroy the family. Imagine kung pareho sila magsasama. Tatawagin ba ang family yan? Hindi. So, panalo si Taning kung walang bata, mag-aadap o kaya aso na lang. So, it is our responsibility to educate our children. Nasabihin natin, mali yan. Hindi yan ang utos ng Diyos. Ito yun, sa akin, ang message dito, defend the family. Because the family is a holy institution created by God. Hindi yan dahil nanligaw ako, nagkagusto ako sa kanya. If it was not willed by the Father or by God, hindi kami magkakasawa, hindi rin kami magkaanak. So merong laws na dapat natin sundin at ipatupad doon sa mga anak natin. Para sila, when they become parents themselves, ganun din ang gagawin. Otherwise, kung susundin nila yung mga uso ngayon, na hindi na yan, okay na yan, talo tayo.
Very good. So, may batas ang Diyos. Hindi yan batas para tayo, no, i-subjugate. It's meant for our good, eh. And when you read the first reading talaga, no, long life, you have peace in your heart, because your sins are forgiven, you'll have children, your prayers are heard, and all of that. Yeah. Yes.
Father, just a point of observation. No wonder the Jews, no? They tell their stories time and again to the children, no? From the great to the, up to now, they tell the story about
they are the stories of their families from the time of Noah, Adam and Eve. Yeah. Abraham, Sarah. They're all stories of the family. Yeah. So it's important how the Jewish covenant now places us in that importance of their Bible, the stories of different families. Yes. Behind a saint is the light that comes from God. Yeah. Actually, the halo is a sign of the sun. S-U-N. Yes.
Samantalihin ko na kasi gusto kong kausapin yung daughter ko. No? Alam mo, kaming mga lalaki, husbands, hindi madali yung role namin as bilang asawa. Kasi hindi naman namin ginusto eh. Pero Diyos yung nag-assign sa amin. Kahit hindi namin gusto, kahit mahirap, sinasabihan, ang alam natin, mga tao, wives, submit to your husbands, even if your husbands are not respectable. On the other hand naman, inutusan kami ng Panginoon na husbands loves your wives even they are not lovable. So napakabigat talaga nung role ng bilang asawa. So dati, parang naiisip ko na ngayon, Father, pag meron kaming fight, sa sinasabi, submit ka sa akin. Pag ayaw naman nung kabilang mag-submit, ayaw mo mag-submit, sige, ako nalang magsasubmit. Siguro yun yung pinaka-proper na sagot ng husband. Kung ayaw mag-submit ang wife, di sabihin, eh, di kami magsasubmit. Yan, thank you po.
Okay. Yeah. Kaya nga sabi sa inyo, yung first five, important. Put on heartfelt compassion, humility, gentleness, kindness and patience, bearing with one another. Those are the ingredients of family life. These are not virtues as much as these are meant for family living. Yeah. Thank you. So I'm happy. Sorry po, next week I'll enter my retreat. Just pray for me. No, but the week after that, I'll be here for the Mass of Sunday of January 7, but I'll be on retreat. So on January 3, Wednesday, I will not leave the retreat house. Ako kasi, I will be on retreat. I'll go to the Abbey, to the Monastery of San Beda in Mendiola to have 6 days of my personal silence, somehow to connect the 2023 to the 2024. For my own spiritual growth. Ano bang gusto ng Diyos sa buhay ko din? No? So, hindi lang palagi nagsasalita, nakikinig din sa Diyos. So, I'll tell that to Father Dave that next week, we don't have a Bible study, nor the Mass for me here. Somebody will have to take my place. Okay. So, with this, nevertheless, meron akong saglit lang po that might come to you. And that's my summary of next Sunday ahead of time. Okay. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit. And may Almighty God bless you all, keep you safe and protected as you go home. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Good night and good evening.